This tutorial is part of our practical database design course. You can find a link to the YouTube playlist for this course in the video description. Alternatively, if you like this course, you can watch the complete course uninterrupted, ad-free, access updated tutorials and download the source code and more from our Udemy course. Again, the link to the course is in the video description. What we have learned so far is that to build and administrate a relational database, we need software, a relational database management system. Popular relational database management systems include MySQL and Postgres database. Using any relational database software, we build databases and then design and implement tables. You may have read or heard the term entity being used to reference what might commonly be called a table in a database. So before we embark on our journey into tables and fields, let's start by stating that table and entity can just be a way of expressing the same concept. If you wanted a deeper understanding why we might use the word entity or table, we need to break down the design process into stages. The first stage, we establish the design of our database. The outcome might be a diagram representing our database design. At this logical stage, as it might be called, we are concerned with ensuring that we are designing our database to a set of design specifications or requirements. Generally, throughout this stage of the development process of our database, we use the term entity to reference what we will know will be eventually be called a table. When we work through the design process in our project, hopefully that will become a little bit clearer as to why we might describe what we will know as a table as an entity. Once we have developed our logical design, we are then concerned with how our design will be implemented within our relational database management system. At this stage, we implement the entities defined in our design as tables in the relational database management system. From this point on, we refer to what was an entity in the logical design stage as a table. Once we start our design process, I will give you some more information and explain entities in more detail. More importantly, at this point, we now understand that an entity is a table that isn't quite an actual table just yet. While we are in the logical design process, or at the start of our design process, I will use the term entity, but as we go deeper into the process, I will start to use the terminology table. While we are in the logical design process at the start of our project, I will use the term entity. But as we go deeper into the process, into our project, I will start to use table, and sometimes I will switch back to entity. Sometimes the context of what we're talking about or how we're referring to our table can also be a reason to use the terminology entity or table.